Hi friends, we would like you to subscribe and also press the bell icon.
Presenting Shriram Life Genius Assured Benefit Plan. ये प्लान आपके और आपके बच्चों के सपनों को पूरा करने में मदद करता है। फिर चाहे उनकी विदेश में पढ़ाई, उनकी शादी या कोई बिजनेस की शुरुआत ही क्यों ना हो, और तो और आपके ना होने पर ये आपके परिवार का ख्याल भी रखता है। अधिक जानकारी के लिए इस नंबर
इधर 60-70% of them use their two-wheelers for their practicing their profession. I have seen people from Andhra Pradesh, that aesthetic sense, looking around for beautiful things and all that. I see it was less in Andhra Pradesh. But then they were able to create wealth. Today, if you look at the United States, the number of people from Andhra Pradesh who are doing very well in I'm taking away your manufacturing. Among all commercial activities, insurance is less dull than others. That's all I would say. I would say it is very interesting. I don't love insurance. Insurance is very dull. So this monitoring, which takes a lot of energy and time and all this, I was never doing. I said, if somebody is doing it well, giving the freedom to do it, maybe he will do it in a different way. You don't have to structure that it has to be done only in this way. He could do it probably in a different way, more effectively than the way you think you can do a particular thing.
I think you
and in the process,
you identifying the person.
இதனை இதனால் இவன் முடிக்கும் என்று ஆய்ந்து அதனை அவன் கண் விடல்.
That was the always.
That was a natural process. ஆய்ந்து means you have to examine, add a lot of parameters and then add all those things. That was the kind of ஆய்ந்திங் was not being done by me. Okay, instinct tells you, as it did to Mr. Bikesha. I would say he was driven by instinct. He would say this person is capable of achieving something. In fact, my colleague who is now, he's almost 90 years old now, Mr. A.C. Mukherjee, in New India Assurance Company, he's now in Calcutta. He joined New India Assurance Company as a management trainee a few years before I joined as a manager. He was, within 6 months or 4 months of training, Mr. Shah called him and said, look, you are going to Sri Lanka. There's a good friend who has started an insurance company, Selinco Insurance Company, and you go and set up their marine department and later on the other departments. And next few months, you have to be assisting them. Mukherjee was taken aback. He said, I am only 6 months as a trainee here. I don't know. How do you think I can do all these things? I have no idea whatsoever. Mr. Shah said, you will be able to do it. You go. He went there and stayed there for 2 years or 3 years and assisted them in creating. Even today, Selinco is the largest and the most respected insurance company in Sri Lanka. How did he choose A.C. Mukherjee out of around 10 or 11 people who were there as trainees who were recruited simultaneously? He chose Mukherjee to do the job. So that way, I had seen Mr. B.K. Shah selecting people specifically for certain positions. They wouldn't have fitted into another position.
But what
they were doing in a particular position at that point of time was something which others could not have done. These are all things which are come to some people naturally.
And another point of this.
That's why I don't very much believe in your management institute and all that.
Sure.
Not with these webinars which are starting, you know how to do this, how to do this. So it keeps people engaged, but I don't think it will have any impact on performance of people. I don't think so.
Another point of dissent I always looked at the American Constitution, sir. It was built for, the Constitution was built for the people who have been, non-conformist from Europe and various parts of Europe. They went to US and they didn't want to follow a very, very heavy religious methods of Catholicism or thinking process, everything restricted. So they want to be a free personality. So they created an American Constitution. It says, a choice is everything in life. So if you want to get destroyed, there are enough places, and if you want to really grow, innovate, there is a constitution. Similarly, you have a left sort of a constitution. It should be shared wealth, not a personal wealth creation. But both these left and right, they never stayed in their extremes. They had to move towards the common. In that, I have seen in your style of functioning, when it comes to your personal wealth creation, you always felt you are a left. When it comes to a right, if it's going to keep people happy, you never discourage them. Suppose they want to go. I remember my own vice chairman was there then in Shriram. Standard 2000 car, if he wants to buy, you would have even cried not to buy, but you never said no. But you were never, even today, I don't think you own a car or you own a personal wealth or whatever it is. So what is there the contradiction in terms of you used to tell people, at the same time today, without the consumerism, Shriram City Union Finance is not there, sir. So there is, that is where I want to
know. No, there I differ, Ramani. We believe, we hope we are right, that Shriram City Union Finance's financing of two-wheelers is not consumption financing.
Not like at that. Least our TV
consumer thing. We don't finance TVs and all that. By and large, our financing has always been
in productive product.
So our two-wheelers, 60-70% of them use their two-wheelers for their practicing their profession, running around here and there and all that. It is not for going to film or taking the family out for hotel or something like that, a restaurant or something like that.
But revenue expenditures you have to have. That's why the chit was there for a revenue expenditure.
It would be there. Yeah. It would also be there. It's not as if you say that these are all things which are prohibited. But the focus or the emphasis will be on providing credit for something which will create an enterprise or an activity which will create wealth, right, rather than for consumption. I have not been able to understand the American approach of consumption-driven economies.
Right.
May not be relevant to India is what I believe. Consumption-driven, consumption will take place when there is wealth. When there is wealth creation, people are going to have a share of the wealth. Then they will start consuming, definitely. That kind of a consumer-driven economy is okay.
Right.
But you cannot simply say already all of you start consuming and then who is there to produce things which can be consumed. So the focus for a society like ours, like most of the societies in this world today, it's not consumption-driven economies you should create. You should create economies which will produce something continuously, more and more efficiently as you go along. So I think in that there will not be any contradiction or anything like that. But situations are very different from one situation is very different from you see things you see in Nigeria, for example, is very different from what you see in India. And what you see in Tamil Nadu is very different from what you see in Maharashtra. There is so much of differences between different societies, which we may not be able to perceive even, but we know that they are very different.
Another quality I have seen, maybe before getting into a few
very interesting, Vangatramani. Yeah. I have seen people from Andhra Pradesh, two things I have observed, that aesthetic sense, looking around for beautiful things and all that, I see it was less in Andhra Pradesh. But then, they were able to create wealth. Today, if you look at the United States, the number of people from Andhra Pradesh who are doing very well in US is much higher than people from Tamil Nadu.
Right.
Similarly, the industrialists in Tamil Nadu, all your textile industry, your Ramasubramanya Rajas, all those people were people who came from Andhra Pradesh.
Right.
The Tamil Nadu did not create so many businessmen as the migrant people from Andhra Pradesh created it. But it goes along with a lack of ability to understand the beautiful things in life. So you don't have much of a good literature in the current literature in Andhra Pradesh. I used to discuss it with my friend. He used to get annoyed. No, we have got one or two people. You don't have a T. Janakiraman there. You don't have a Pudumai Pithan in Andhra Pradesh. You do not have a K. Balachandar. Maybe they will say we had on Vishwanath, Satyanarayana, Vishwanath.
Vishwanath.
K. Vishwanath. There might be one or two. But the kind of a person that K. Balachandar is, you did not have. So, these two things, again, personalities.
Okay.
Between one population and another, there are genetic variances of a minor kind. It is there. A few things I have observed, though I can't create a theory for it, these are all accidental. It doesn't mean that automatically it happens. But in certain communities or in certain geographies, there is a higher percentage of gifted people.
Mm-hmm.
It happened. Historically, it has developed. It is not God-given, but it's an accident.
I see.
When I say accident, when you toss this, I keep talking to people. They don't believe sometimes. But when you toss a coin, it could be head or tails. I have been telling them.
Yes,
so people don't believe that you toss a coin 50 times.
Mm-hmm.
once all the 50 will be heads. People find it difficult to believe, but that is true. As a probabilist, I would say it is certain that in one of those experiments of tossing a coin 50 times, and in one of those experiments where you are tossing a coin 1,000 times, 1,000 heads will come. And 1,000,000 heads will come in one of those. It is a certainty. It's not something which may happen. No, it will happen. Similarly, this strengths of a particular kind and weaknesses in a particular kind has got a, I would say, a distribution of a particular kind in a society. Because in those days, societies were not intermingling to the extent that they are doing today. Today, there is more of intermingling of people and all that in the United States than in India.
Sure.
In earlier days, it was much less in India, and therefore, certain characteristics settled down in certain. That way, I found that Andhra Pradesh had entrepreneurship combined with a lack of aesthetic sense. It gives me satisfaction to say that you are weakness probably in one area, which is all right. Because they are creating wealth for the community, therefore it is very good.
Even if they go to New Hyderabad, which is created, or
again, Gujarat also, you will see. Yeah. Gujarat has not created any musicians.
Yeah.
Marathi, there are a lot of musicians. First class, Bhimsen Joshi. Bhimsen Joshi was a Kannadiga, he was not a Maharashtrian.
But
Bhimsen Joshi was in that border place. But many Maharashtrian musicians, creators of music had been there. You don't see anyone from Gujarat. Oh, Deepak Raja will come for a fight with me if I say so. But it is true that you don't have musicians as you have from Bengal, for example. You have from Bengal, you have from Maharashtra, you don't have any from.
I mean, I could understand. So basically, a sort of a baniya or a businessman.
That success.
That success has been more in Andhra Pradesh.
It has evolved. It was surfaced like that. The talent for being successful in business was there. The talent for being artistic was there here.
Yeah.
That was less in a particular population, more of it in certain population. That's why populations of personalities, like human personalities, populations' personalities also vary.
Okay, more on the management, sir, is the last question. After that, we'll just go into some very loved subject of yours, insurance. We shall come to it later. Just last question.
I don't love insurance. Insurance is very dull.
I know, but anyway, I will come to that. I meant insurance to the extent of the beliefs and optimism and
I would only say this. Among all commercial activities, yeah. I'm taking away your manufacturing. Among all commercial activities, insurance is less dull than others. That's all I would say. I would say it is very interesting. It is less dull than, for example, money lending or financing.
Okay. So, now, the point I was trying to arrive at was, I see it in Shriram Group culture, very, very significant culture, or it has been propagated by you, or I would say you would have...
You say evolved. Use the word evolved. It has evolved.
Okay,
in nobody
sir,
created it.
Really evolved. Okay. But the trigger point was, you always said, any success is a group responsibility. Similarly, failure can be taken by the leader, but success comes, it is a group's responsibility. So, there is no particular pressure on any one person performing very well, that you have been always advocating against it. I think that is how the evolving of Shriram Group came. That has reduced the pressure on the system for performance. But the best performance has been coming. How did you arrive at that as a combination? And is it again?
I asked you. I told you right at the beginning. Don't ask me the question. How and what?
Okay. In your experience, how did that?
As my friend said, it just happens.
It just happens.
When my professor was asking me that question, he said, it just happens.
But this gives a lot of tension free, sir, less tensions. There won't be many suicides in the executive ladders. In our organization, everybody is very comfortable. Now, I used to think, why can't we just do something against whatever RT has been practicing? I did meet some very few success, but a lot of failures. In the sense, like, why can't I try differently? But I think you have managed to...
See, ultimately, Ramani, whether you try one way or the other,
again,
what is in you will come out.
Yeah.
You can't, by going to IIM Ahmedabad, you are not going to change the way you are going to interact with people, interact with situations. It won't change at all. It will not.
Okay, now what I wanted to get into insurance, why it was, sir, the organization has grown really in terms of the financial services or retail financial services, touching the productivity for the society, the financial has been doing well. Now the organization is becoming very, very significant in terms of life insurance and general insurance. And there also, it has been a totally different methods. What you have, what compared to any other insurance company, what we see is lesser capital than any of the insurance company, are a great performance. But it really says that you have been saying that performance of a company, efficiency index is profit and reserve what you have created. So that has all been happening. But in, I just wanted to this to touch this question so that you can take as many minutes as you want. Then we can close the interview. What I want to know is the insurance awareness in terms of a personal or a vehicle or a general insurance. The awareness is so low. And you have been even advocating me or people like me, go and tell people the woes of not getting the insurance. And then you also said Indian community may be more higher in terms of people think kadaval paathuvar, or destiny, or optimism. These three qualities are much more. So what do you think, where are the CEOs or, and you also said the promoters may not know so much because they are very optimistic and driven by their growth. The CFOs or CEOs are all going by the lenders who have given money. So they just suggest some insurance, they go by it. So what is that message you want to give it to the people on insurance, basically?
You see, to appreciate the need for insurance, a person should have the ability to imagine something in the future. It's not given to everybody to be in a position to imagine the future. What you see in front of you is the present. The present is dominating your mind all the time.
Right.
To move away from the present and imagine what is going to be there at the end of 5 years, at the
so
end of 10 years.
Then you can't give paranoia for somebody.
The right, the healthy kind of paranoia is okay.
That's what
you may think that I will die. I can die suddenly. I can go in a car and meet with an accident and die. You should be able to see that. A risk-aware person is able to see that.